Hey guys, it's Megan. I always get a ton of questions about how I made my website, the theme I used, and all that fun stuff. So in today's video, I'll be showing you the best way to create your own website for your personal brand, online store, blog, or really any type of website that you can think of. I've personally had my own website for about a year now, and it's basically just an extension of my YouTube channel. I've always wanted to have my own blog. I tried to teach myself how to code and build a website from scratch in high school, but let's just say I did not exactly get very far. So I'm super excited that Wix offered to sponsor today's video. To make your own website, go to wix.com/go/MeganWeller. Down here I have my website that I already made, but when you first start, you're going to want to click Create New Site. Then it'll ask you what kind of website you want to make. You can create an online store, a portfolio, a blog, there are so many different options. Since I wanted to create my own blog, that's the option that I chose. Next, it'll ask you to choose how you want to create your website. You can let the Wix ADI create a website for you, which basically involves answering a few questions and it'll set the website up for you automatically. Or you can choose to create your website with the Wix editor, which is what I did. One of my favorite things about Wix is that they give you so many templates to choose from. For my website, I chose the Arts and Crafts blog template. Navigating through your Wix website is super intuitive. To navigate to the different pages, you'll want to select the Menus and Pages button. Then you can check out each page, delete any pages that you don't want by clicking the three dots next to the name, and selecting Delete from the drop-down menu, and add in any pages that you do want by selecting the Add Page button. If you want to create a drop-down menu like this one that I have on my site, go to the Add a Folder button. You can arrange the order of the menu items by dragging them where you want them. To add pages to the drop-down menu, add a new page, name it, and drag it underneath the folder. Click the three dots and click Subpage. Now, when you go to preview your site, you can hover over the menu item and your pages that you put underneath it will show up. If you don't love the menu on the template that you selected, you can choose a new one by clicking the plus button, Menu, and just replacing it. If you click the square on the left of the page, you can change your site background. I left mine white since I was going for a cleaner, more minimal look, but there's lots of different colors and images to choose from. The tool that I probably use the most is the plus button. Here you can add text, images, videos, music, and all kinds of stuff. One of my favorite things about Wix is that they provide so many free images and illustrations. You can create different boards to save your images too. To save an image, hover over it, click Add to My Boards, and select the board you'd like to add it to. When you're ready to add an image to your page, just select it, click Add to Page, and you can move it around and resize it as necessary. If you want to add additional functions to your website, like your Instagram feed, an online store, Google Drive, a podcast player, anything like that, go to the fourth button down on the left. Underneath that is the Media section, which holds all your photos, and then there's the Blog Manager, which really only applies if you have a blog. Now that we've gone through the basics, let's get into my actual website. I already had most of it set up, but I felt like it needed to be refreshed a little bit. While I was going through the Wix image library, I found this image of a hand that was drawing, and that gave me an idea for a new homepage design. I just sped this section up though, because it ended up that I didn't like it. It looked okay on the desktop version, but I wasn't a huge fan of how it looked on mobile. That's something that's super important to keep in mind when creating your site. Before you hit publish, you should always make sure that everything looks good on mobile. And if you don't like something that's on mobile, you can just move it around and it won't mess with the desktop version. Luckily, if you don't like something that you've done, you can just click the undo button in the upper right until your site's back how you want it. The page that I actually did end up updating was my About Me page. This is the page that I link to on all of my social media, since they usually only let you put one link in your bio. Even if you aren't ready to have a full website, I still think that it's a really good idea for everyone to have a page like this. Before, I just had the name of each platform with a link underneath it, which is fine, but it's not the most professional looking. If you go to the plus button over on the left, then go down to social, you'll find a few different social media buttons you can choose from. And obviously I needed the YouTube one. All you have to do is set your channel by putting in the link. I also added a Pinterest follow button, which is the same exact process, just select the button and enter the link to your Pinterest profile. For the text box, I deleted the links and put the social buttons where the links had been. Adding my Instagram was a little bit trickier. Since there isn't an Instagram button, I added a social bar and deleted everything except for Instagram. I plugged in my link and replaced the icon with a different one. To make it more symmetrical with the other links, I added a new text box and wrote out my username. I made it red to kind of match the other logos. Something else that's pretty cool is that you can link text to another website. Click Edit Text, the link button, select what you'd like the text to link to, and enter the URL. The other two links I have are Redbubble and Famous Birthdays. Since neither of them are really social medias, I had to get creative. I went to the plus button again, clicked Image, My Uploads, and Upload Media. I added in a PNG of the Redbubble logo and put it on the page. Once it was the right size, I selected the image, link, and entered my link. I did the same thing with the text that I did before, and repeated the process with my Famous Birthdays link. And just like I said earlier, the most important thing is to check how your site looks on mobile, and fix things if necessary. Your Wix site will save automatically every few minutes, but it's always a good idea to save your changes before you log out. Your changes won't go live until you click the blue Publish button in the upper right. And one last thing that I wanted to show you guys is that if you put your Instagram feed on your site, you can add links to your Instagram posts. Just click on your feed, Settings, Add Links, select the post, and add in your link. I always wondered how people did that, and apparently I spent all that time wondering for nothing. So here's my finished website. If you want to make your own, head over to wix.com/go/MeganWeller to get started. And if you want to check out the website that I made, you can find it at www.meganweller.org. So thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more videos just like this one. My merch, my website, and all of my social media will be linked down below. A huge thank you to Wix for sponsoring this video. And yeah, I love you guys so much, and I will see you guys later. Bye!